Hello, hello, everybody. It is 3:06 p.m. Central Time on Wednesday, August 2nd, 2017. And you are here on the Earthquake 3D live stream. I'm doing a quick update for my viewers down in New Zealand and for in South America. Today has been a busy day, and several of the locations we had issue forecast for have now been hit. This includes the Kermadec Islands just north of the Catcher's Mitt. You can see the North Catcher's Mitt position. I call it Catcher's Mitt because it looks like one, and it also functions like one when pressure is coming down from the north. And over the past several days, you've had multiple 4 and a 5.0 earthquake deep down below the letter D, which stands for deep earthquake, in case you don't know. Well, since then, we've seen activity north of New Zealand and south of New Zealand, but nothing at the center yet. Well, this now, again, another 5.3 earthquake at the Kermadec, north of the Catcher's Mitt. We were talking about watching for this last night. If you tuned into the update last night, we were talking about Catcher's Mitt looking there between there and the tip of the red arrow. So looking between this Catcher's Mitt position here, the tip of the thumb, and the red arrow. And now look where the 5.3 is. There it is. So, 5.3 struck the warned area. That's on top of Myanmar getting hit at the India border, or India getting hit at the Myanmar border. And that's also on top of the South Sandwich Islands getting hit on our letter X and the letter X at the middle point of the Atlantic. That's at the Romanche Fracture Zone, or near the Romanche Fracture Zone getting hit. Finally, for my South American viewers, look where our arrow points, our northern arrow. I mean, right on the money, one magnitude less than expected. So we were looking for 5, and it comes in at 4, but guess what else is going on right here? Multiple volcanic blasts at Reventador Volcano in Ecuador, which, as we know, multiple volcanic blasts, as I've said in many videos going back many years, each blast is equal to about a 5.0 earthquake. So, in other words, on one side, we get a 4.0 earthquake and a series of eruptions. And on the other side, where the other arrow points, we get a series of mid-range 5s, 5.5 and 5.6, all within the last day and a half. The only spot left to be hit is the middle, and it should be hit by a combination of the two on either side. So when you see a 4 in a series of blasts to the north and a series of mid-range 5s to the south, you look to the middle for something that's a combination between the two, which goes up into the upper 5 range. So I hope you guys understand what's going on right now. The halfway silent points, the fulcrum points. Here's another good example. This 5.3 down here, look, it's in between our deep earthquake to the north and the clusters to the south. Here, let me turn on the ring so you can get a better idea. Okay, so it's the halfway point, and each halfway point is being hit. That's why Myanmar was hit. Finally, I would like to also report on something else. A upper 5 near 6.0 earthquake was reported at the Iraq-Kuwait border. 10-kilometer depth, USGS EMSC, not reporting the earthquake, but it is on the seismologist study page. So last time I checked, it's on the seismologist study page. Maybe we should go over together and quickly check it and see if it's still there. I mean, I showed it in a video, but I mean, video proof is good enough, but I'd like for you guys to be able to see it real time with me. Go over to the EMSC page, the European Mediterranean Agency, and let's click on seismologists. Go over to the data contributions, go down, find the earthquake. Where is it? Where is it? Ah, here it is. Now, there were 17 stations reporting. Yeah, 17 phase arrivals, 18 station magnitudes. And they go anywhere 5.1, 4.8, 5.0, 4.9, 4.5, 5.2, 5.0, 4.7, 5.4, 5.1. Then we go up a notch, two stations reporting 6.9 and 7. We'll throw those out because those are obviously body magnitude wrong readings, or it was a strong motion very close to the stations. I doubt that, though. So we'll throw out the high ends, and we're left with 5s. 5s going up to near 6. So it's an upper 5 to 6.0 earthquake striking at the Iraq-Kuwait border, and it's right on our red arrow. And it's right on for the warning we issued for Iran that they were going to get hit again. So Iran at the Iraq border, Iraq at the Iran border, Kuwait's right there, and it's down below in the crust. Auto sign 10 km depth, which means it's not a surface quake, which means it's not a blast. Okay, so there we go. What do we got going on here? Near the coast of central Chile at 20:03, another earthquake? Really? Really? Hold on. Got another earthquake, guys. Let's hit refresh. See what we got going on down here. Atacama, Chile. Yep. There you go. Okay, guys. Now, this is on top of the 5.3 that just hit just a little while ago. Here, let me show it to you. Okay. So, just looking at the map here, there's our previous 5.5 down to the south. This one is more to the north. It's more where the previous earthquake... And it's not even there. It's actually next to where the previous earthquake struck. We got some big-time movement going on down here in the past day. So what's going on here? This cluster. Look at the big arrow. See the big arrow? Look where the big arrow points. Obviously, right? Points right to the earthquakes. Trace the big arrow back. Where does it go? And let's go back a few days. And there's our deep earthquakes. Raised high off the globe. So the deep 4.5 happened on July 31st. The deep 4.7 happened on July 29th. The deep 5.1 happened on July 30th. So 29th, 30th, 31st, three deep earthquakes took 2.5, 3 days to reach over to South America. Like I said, up to the north, Reventador volcano blowing over and over again in a new four. And down to the south, we get multiple mid-range fives since there's no blasts to absorb some of that pressure. Ultimately, new multiple mid-range fives means we have to watch out for two things. One, the middle point should be hit. It should be hit by a combination of the two on both sides. Secondly, we have to watch down here now for the potential of a large earthquake. You don't get this kind of movement without there being the potential of a large earthquake to mix in here. So you get multiple mid-range fives spreading out. How far apart do you think those are? You want to find out? I'd say it's at least a couple hundred miles, but, I mean, there is a way to find out. We have to go do a line measurement tool. Let's do it. Screw it. Let's do it. Let's get a copy of Google Earth open. And let's turn on display capture so you can see what I see. Okay, Lampa, Chile is where the 5.5 hit earlier today, right? Yeah. Okay, and we'll put those coordinates in first. So paste, search. Okay, and let's mark it just so it's easy to find. We'll just leave it untitled place mark. That's fine. Now let's get the coordinates for the other earthquake far to the north, the one in green. Offshore of Atacama, Chile. And same thing, coordinates. Now check it out. USGS not reporting the earthquake yet. Yeah, we don't like that. Yeah, did you get that TCP memo? I'm looking for my red stapler. Okay, so let's measure our distance in miles since we're here in the States. You know, miles allows for a little bit more creativity of thinking, I think. I think inches and miles allow for more creative thinking. And if you're going to be doing, you know, very fine measurements or something, then you would maybe want to start using the metric system. But if you're into abstract thinking and, you know, that kind of stuff, use miles and inches. You'll find it much more conducive to thought. So here we are, 335 miles apart within the same day. Now in kilometers, that's 540 kilometers. So guys, we're talking about a large distance moving right now, and it also goes over to the east. You know what? Let's go ahead and get that one as well. How far to the east is that 5.6? Vincina, Argentina. Okay. Copy and paste. There we go. All right, let's mark it between the two. How far is it to the east? Guess we'll do it in kilometers first. That'd be easier. It's roughly 379 kilometers or 235 miles. So somebody could compute the square mileage on that by going between the three points and finding the area in between in this somewhat isosceles triangle. So there we go. There is the earthquake pressure giving way where the pressure hits. Oh, new upgrade on the earthquake down here. They may have changed the coordinates or something. They just changed it somehow. Somehow they just updated the 5.3 north of New Zealand. So looking at it, you can see one,